Hello students, today I am going to discuss about the topic standard and canonical form. Today we are going to cover min term, max term, expression functions as a sum of min term and product of max terms, canonical forms, standard forms, two level implementation of standard forms. So let us start with what is min term. Consider a system of three input signal variables x, y and z. A term which ANDs all input variable either in true or complement form is called a min term. Thus, consider three input system as eight min terms, namely x bar, y bar, z bar, comma x bar, y bar, z, x bar, y, z bar, x bar, y, z, x, y bar, z bar, x, y bar, z, x, y, z bar, and x, y, z. Each min term equals 1 at exactly one particular input combination, and it is equal to 0 at all other combinations. So for example, x bar, y bar, z bar is always equal to 0 except for the input combination x, y, z is equals to 0, 0, 0, where it is equivalent to 1. So accordingly, the min term x bar, y bar, z bar is referred as m naught. In general, min terms are designated as MI, where I corresponds to the input combination at which this min term is equal to 1. So for the three input system under consideration, the number of possible input combination is 2 power 3 or 8. This means that the system has a total number of 8 min terms as follows. Say for example, if it is a 4 input combination, then 2 power 4 is equals to 16 combinations are there. So if there are 8 min terms, then it starts with M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. Okay. So which is equivalent to, say for example, min term is equals to x bar, y bar, z bar, which is equivalent to 0, 0, 0. Otherwise, it is equivalent to 0. Okay. In general, for n input variables, the number of min terms is equals to the total number of possible input combination, which is equivalent to 2 power n. A min term is equals to 0 at all input combinations except 1, where the min term is equals to 1. Say for example, what is the number of min terms for a function with input variables? Number of min term is equals to, for 5 input variables, number of min terms is equals to 2 power 5, then it is equivalent to 32 min terms. Got it? So I'll repeat. Say for example, the number of min terms want to calculate according to the input variable is 2 power number of inputs. So the question here is, what is the number of min terms for a function with 5 input variables? Number of min terms is equals to 2 power 5, which gives 35 min terms. Let us see what is max term. Consider a circuit of three input signals variables x, y and z. A term which ADDs all input variables either in true or complement form is called a max term. So with three input variables, the system considering as a total of 8 max term, namely x plus y plus z, x plus y plus z bar, x plus y bar plus z, x plus y bar plus z bar, x bar plus y plus z, x bar plus y plus z bar, x bar plus y bar plus z, and x bar plus y bar plus z bar. So every min term equals 0 at exactly one of the 8 possible input combinations, and it is equal to 1 at all other combinations. Say for example, x plus y plus z equals 1 at all input combination except for the combination x, y, z is equals to 0, 0, 0, where it is equal to 0. So accordingly, the max term x plus y plus z is referred as m naught. Max terms are designated MI, where I corresponds to the input combination at which this max term is equals to 0. For the three input system, the number of possible input combination is 2 power 3 or 8, so which is similar to min term. Here we are using R, in max term we are using AND gate. So this means the system has of total of 8 max term are as follows, and it, the max term is represented with capital letter M, and it start with M0, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, M6, M7. n input variable, the number of max terms is equal to the total number of possible input combinations, which is equal to 2 power n. So a max term is equal to 1 at all the combinations except 1 where the max term is equal to 0. So using De Morgan's theorem or truth table, it can be easily shown as mi is equal to mi bar. Expressing function as sum of min terms. So sum of min terms is nothing but we are going to add all the min terms. It is also called a sum of product. Okay. So consider a function f defined by the shown truth table. Okay. That is m. F is equals to m2 plus m4 plus m5 plus m7. So now let us rewrite the table with few added columns. Column I indicating the input. See, this is a function, okay, which is defined in the truth table, m2 plus m4 plus m5 plus m7. So now let us rewrite the table with few added columns. A column I indicating the input combination. So this is an input combination. I indicates the input combination. Four columns of min terms, m2, m4, m5, m7. Okay, one last column, R in the above min terms, that is m2 plus m4 plus m5 plus m7. So from this table, we can clearly see that f is equals to m2 plus m4 plus m5 plus m7. So we are adding R, we are adding all the min terms. So we are using R, adding all the min terms, which is called a sum of min terms. In general, any function can be expressed by R-ing all min terms corresponding to the input combination at which the function has a value of 1. So the resulting expression is commonly referred as sum of min terms, and it is typically expressed as f is equals to summation of 2, 4, 5, 7, where summation indicates R of the indicated min term. So thus f is equals to summation of 2, 4, 5, 7, which is equivalent to m2, m4, m5, m7. So consider the example with f and f complement. So the truth table of f complement shows that f complement equals to 1 at I is equals to 0, 1, 3 and 6. So here you can see the f complement output value is for 0 it is 1, for the input combination 1 is 1, and for 3 is 1, and for 6 is 1. Okay, so this we can also write as f complement is equals to m0 plus m1 plus m3 plus m6, because these combination of min term we got the output 1. So this can also be written as f complement is equals to 0, summation of 0, 1, 3, 6. Okay. And f is equals to summation of f is equals to summation of 2, 4, 5, 7. So the sum of all min term expression of f complement contains all min terms that do not appear in the sum of min term expression of f. See, for f complement we have 0, 1, 3, 6. F is nothing but if the number which is not in the function, then that can be taken as f. Expressing function as a product of sum. Using De Morgan's theorem on the equation, as you are aware, the De Morgan's theorem is a b whole bar is equals to a bar plus b bar. So we can also rewrite, we can rewritten the expression as a b bar is equals to a bar plus b bar. At the same way, a bar into b bar, which is also can be written as a plus b whole bar. So the same concept applies here. So f bar is equals to m bar plus m2 plus m4 plus m5 plus m7 whole bar can also be written as m2 bar into m4 bar into m5 bar into m7. So which is equivalent to m2 into m4 into m5 into m7. So this form is designated as a product of max terms, and it is expressed using the pi symbol. So which is used to designate product in regular algebra, but it is used to designate AND in the Boolean algebra. So in the sum of product, we are adding all the product. So here, all the sum can be multiplied by using AND gate. So that is the difference between sum of product and product of sum. So let us see an example. F bar is equals to f bar is equals to pi of 2 comma 4 comma 5 comma 7 is equals to m2 m4 m5 m7, and this can also be written as this is product of sum, and from that you can also write sum of product. F is equals to summation of 0 comma 1 comma 3 comma 6 is equals to pi of 2 comma 4 comma 5 comma 7. So expressing function as sum of min term or product of max term. Any function can be expressed both as sum of min term, that is summation mi, and as a product of max term. The notation used for indicating product of max term is pi mj, capital Mj. So the product of max term expression of f contains all the max term that do not appear in the sum of min term expression of f. The sum of min term expression of f complement contains all min term, but they do not appear in the sum of min term expressions of f. So because this is true for all the complementary function, each of the 2 power n min term will appear either in the sum of min term expression of f or the sum of min term expression of f bar, but not both. Okay. The product of max term expressions of f bar contains all max term that do not appear in the product of max term expression of f. This is true for all complementary function. Each of the 2 power n max term will appear either in the product of max terms expression of f or the product of max term expression of f bar, but not both. Expressing function as sum of min term or product of sum. Let us have an example. Given that f of a comma b comma c comma d is equals to summation of 0 1 2 4 5 7. So here derive the product of max term expression of f and the 2 standard form expression of f bar. So since the system has 4 input variable, the number of min term and max term is equals to 2 power 4 is equals to 16. So here you can see the number of max term and min term for the given input combination is 2 power 4 is equals to 16. So for the given example, f of a comma b comma c comma d is equals to 0 1 2 4 5 7. So here from this you can write product of sum, that is f is equals to pi of whatever numbers which are missing. And for 4 input variables, the numbers you can write here are 3, 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So these are all the product of sum. Similarly, if it is sum of product, then you can also write a product of sum from this given number. Let us take finding the sum of min term from a given expression. So let us find out. Let us have an example. Let f of a comma b comma c is equals to a into b plus a bar c. Express f as a sum of min term. See, as we know that it is not in a canonical form. As you can see, this is not in a canonical form. This is a general form. Canonical form in the sense, in the Boolean expression, there are many, there are more than one term that forms Boolean function or Boolean expression. Every term has all the variables. If any one variable is missing in that Boolean function or expression, then it is not said to be a standard or canonical form. Okay. So if it is not, you can make it as canonical form. So now the example given here is general form. So you have to express this as a sum of min term. So f of a comma b comma c is equals to a b into whatever variable missing in the first term that can be added by means of OR gate. That is, the missing term for the first term is c variable. So c plus c bar plus a bar c, the missing variable for the second term is b. So b plus b bar. So multiplying, associating with this a b into c plus a b into c bar plus a bar b c plus a bar b bar c, you will get a sum of product. Okay. So this is the way how a standard sum of product can be derived. Operations on function. So the AND operation on two functions corresponds to the intersection of the two sets of min terms of the function. So the OR operation on two functions corresponds to the union of the two set of min terms of the function. Say for example, let a of A, let f of a comma b comma c is equals to summation m of 1 comma 3 comma 6 comma 7, and g of a comma b comma c is equals to summation m of 0 1 2 4 6 7. Okay, so now let us take the common min term represented in the two functions. So the common are 1 6 and 7. Okay, so this is for product, and if we do OR operator, we have to combine all together, 0 1 2 3 4 6 7. If it is more than ones, then you have to write only ones. Commonly you can write. So what is f bar into g? So f bar, you have to take whatever the missing number, whatever number which is not present here, that has to be taken as f bar. So 0, 2, 4, 5. Now you have g already. So multiplying these two, combining these two, what is common? F into g, what is common? 0 is common, 2 is common, and 4 is common. Okay, so hope you understand this simple problem. Now let us come to the canonical form. As I discussed about canonical form as one line, let us see in detail about canonical forms. So the sum of mean term and the product of max term forms a Boolean expression, or known as canonical form. So canonical form means that all the equivalent function will have a unique and equivalent representation. Okay, which means that the term which is used in the a product of max term or a sum of a product have an equal number of variable. Every term should be equal. Okay, if it is equal, then it is called as canonical or standard form. So two functions are equal if and only if they have the same sum of min terms and the same product of max term. Say for example, the function f1 is equals to a bar b bar plus ac plus bc bar, and other function f2 is equals to a bar c bar plus ab plus b bar c. These both are equal. Let us see. Okay, so f1 is equals to a bar plus b bar plus ac plus bc bar. So what is the number for this 0 1 2 5 6 7? F2 is equals to a bar c bar plus ab plus b bar c. So the number for this is 0 1 2 5 6 7. So they are equal as they have same set of mean terms. Okay, standard form. A product term is a term with ANDed literals. Thus AB, A bar B, A bar CD are all product terms, but it is not a standard form because the first two terms have a missing variable. Okay, so there is a missing variable. Since we used a D, there are four variables. So every term should have four variables. So a min term is a special case of a product term where all the input variables appear in the product term, either in the true or complementary form. Okay. So the sum term is a term with R'd literals. Thus A plus B, comma A bar plus B plus A bar plus C bar C plus D are all sum terms. Or they are all sum terms, but they are not canonical form. So a max term is a special case of a sum term where all input variables either in true form or complementary form are ORed together. That is what we call the standard. So Boolean functions can generally be expressed in the form of sum of product or in the product of a sum. The sum of min term form is a special case of the sum of product form where all product terms are min terms. The product of max term form is a special case of the product of sum from where all the sum terms are max terms. So the SOP and the POS forms are standard forms for representing Boolean function. So let us see the two level implementation of a standard form. Okay, any SOP expression can be implemented in two levels of gates. The first level consists of a number of AND gates which equals to the number of product terms in the expression. Each AND gate implements one of the product terms in the expression. So the second level consists of single OR gate whose number of inputs equals the number of product terms in the expression. Okay, let us see the two-level implementation of standard forms. In this example, the following SOP function is given as f is equals to xz plus y bar z plus x bar y z. So in the level 1, we use AND gate, first level, and the second level we use OR gate. So you can able to see this picture. In this circuit, x bar we have one two input AND gate, and y bar z is an another AND gate, and x bar y z is an third AND gate. So this is the first level we use AND gate, and in the second level we are combined together, we are adding all, we are summing all the products by using OR gate. Okay, so two level implementation, level 1 AND gates, level 2 one OR gate. Same way, product of expression can be implemented in two levels of gates. First level consists of number of OR gates, which equals the number of sum terms in the expression. Each gate implements one of the sum term in the expression. So the second level consists of single AND gate, whose number of inputs equals the number of sum term. So let us see the diagrammatic representation. So in this example, implement the following product of sum function. So here you can see there are, in the first level there are three OR gate, x plus z, y bar plus z, x bar plus y plus z. First level we are using OR gates, second level we are using one AND gate. Okay, we'll see few more points about this canonical and standard form with an example. Okay, so as we discussed earlier about canonical and canonical form, let us continue with discussing few example about canonical and standard form. Okay, so already we saw there are two types of canonical form. One is sum of product and product of sum. So generally, sum of product or product of sum, which is in the form of Boolean expression, it is not the simplest form. It can also be minimized, and it is derived from the truth table. So here you can see a clear picture about sum of product canonical form. So it is also called as distinctive normal form and commonly called a minterm expansion. So as you can see, there are two in this truth table. As I said earlier, it is derived from the truth table. So in this truth table given, for three input variable, there are eight combination, and you have two output line f, f bar. So for this f output line, the number of output, there is the output value you got for the input combination is 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. So the term which we written is already we saw how to represent the min term. Okay, so for that f is equals to a bar b bar c, a bar b c, a b bar c, a b c bar a b c. So all the products are summed together, which is also equal to a bar b bar c, can be represented as 0 0 1, which is also equivalent binary value is 0 0 1, and for here 0 1 1 and 1 0 1 1 1 0. So min terms, variable appears exactly once in each min term in true or complementary form. Okay, so here you can see this min term can also be this min term can be represented with m0 to m7 shortened notation we can use. So f in canonical form, okay, f of a comma b comma c 1 3 5 6 7, which is equal to m1 m3 m5 m6 m7. So a bar b bar c plus a bar b c plus a b bar c plus a b c bar plus a b. Okay, and you can also minimize the canonical form. So the minimization we will see later. Minimizing this expression, you will get a b plus c. And product of some canonical form, it is also called as conjunctive normal form. Okay, sum of product is distinctive, here conjunctive normal form, which is commonly called a max term expression. Okay, so here we have a three input variable. The same way sum of product uses product or product, here we use sum. Okay, every term we use OR gate to represent the Boolean expression. Okay, and here see, it is a reverse process where we use inverse in sum of product. Here we use a plus b plus c, which is equal to 0 0 0. A plus b bar plus c, which is equal to 0 1 0. A bar plus b plus c is equals to 1 0 0. So variable appears exactly once in each max term. Okay, the same way you can also minimize this canonical form. And this is the canonical implementation of f is equals to ab plus c. So they are not actually reduced form of form for f. So here this diagram circuit is for canonical sum of product, and this one is for canonical product of sums. Okay. Conversions between canonical form. So let us see how to convert min term to max term. So for converting min term to max term, use max terms that are not in the min term expansion. Say for example, f of a comma b comma c is equals to summation of m of 1 comma 3 comma 5 comma 6 comma 7. Now I want to convert this min term to max term. Okay. So to convert this, whatever number missing in this, that number you can take for the max term. Okay, this is min term, I am converting into max term. So what are the missing numbers? 0 to 4. So that is what we call this conversion of one form into other form. Now for the same, similarly for max term to min term, use min term that are not in the max term expansion. So we have to use min term that are not in the max term. So what are the missing numbers here? 1, 3, 5, 6, 7. Okay. And min term of f to min term of f bar. So here in order to do f inverse, use min term that do not appear. Say for example, a of b comma c is equals to summation of m. So to complement this f of a comma b comma c, then how we can convert whatever missing number here, the same min term number can be taken for f inverse. For max term f to max term f bar, similarly the same way, the missing number, the whatever number that do not appear, that number you can take for f bar. So sum of product, product of sum, and De Morgan's theorem. Okay, so sum of product f bar is equals to a bar b bar c bar plus a bar b c bar plus a bar a b bar c bar. So when you apply De Morgan's law to get the product of sum, say for example I am applying f bar whole bar, which is equivalent to a bar b bar c bar plus a bar, B C bar plus A B bar C bar whole bar. This can also be written as, if you cancel this, you will get F. And here, if you apply this, which is equivalent to A plus B plus C, A plus B bar C, B bar plus C, A bar plus B plus C. So, which is equivalent, when you can also get sum of product into product of sum by applying De Morgan's theorem. Okay. And similarly, for product of sum, if you want to convert product of sum into sum of product, you can also apply De Morgan's theorem. Okay. Next topic in the next session.